Hi friends, welcome. Today's BC about the Thomas Alva Edison, written by Egon Larson. Introduction. Egon Larson in his essay and Thomas Alva Edison present a graphic account of his career in the newspaper world and the scientific ventures. As an inquisitive young man, Edison pestered everyone he met with questions about anything and everything that he saw. The first venture which Edison started was based on the kitchen garden at the back of his house. He produced all he could in his little garden, but it was not enough to meet the growing demand for vegetables in his native place. He often went on business trips to buy vegetables to Detroit. To spend his spare time usefully at Detroit, he became a member of Eggman's Club. Edison's experience as a newspaper boy and editor. To convert the monotonous train journey into a profitable one, Edison started selling the newspaper Detroit Free Press to the passengers every day. When the news of the death of the General Johnston reached Detroit, Edison exploited the opportunity to make a neat sum of money. With the help of the telegraphist, he flashed the news to all stations saying that the details would be available in the evening newspaper. He sold 1,000 copies instead of 200 on that day. At the age of 15, he bought a printing press and began to produce his own paper, the Weekly Herald. He continued his work at the luggage van. Unfortunately, there was a fire accident in the luggage van and Edison was pushed out of the train and not permitted to continue the business in the train. The printed machine, which was intact, was installed in the cellar of his father's house. The Weekly Herald was renamed Fall Fry and it dealt with the fables and fads of the bigwigs of Port Huron. Offended by an article that appeared in Fall Fry, one local business tortured him and it put an end to his career in the newspaper world. Edison's first invention and his first patent. Edison's first invention was a world recorder. He demonstrated his inventions to a committee of the House of Representatives, but they did not evince interest in his machine. He turned his attention to stock exchange ticker. He had an idea of a new system. He went to New York to find buyers and backers around Wall Street. With the help of his friend, he got accommodation in the battery room of the Gold Indicator Company. The simple telegraph installed in the company indicated the varying prices of precious metal. Suddenly, the transmitter of the gold reporting telegraph stopped. The superintendent could not set the right machine. Messenger boys from the subscribing stock brokers stormed into the building and shouted at the superintendent. Edison, who was watching the scene, came forward to help them. He found out what was wrong with the machine and repaired it without much difficulty. As a reward for his timely help, he was appointed the superintendent of the company. He was paid $300 a month, which he never expected. Mr. Law sold his company to a rival firm. The new president of the company requested Edison to suggest measures for improving the tape system. Edison invented a new machine, the Edison Universal Printer, for which he took out a patent. The president of the company, Mr. Lefferts, offered him $40,000 for his patent. Edison's inventions of phonograph and the electric lamp. Edison succeeded in the working out a new system which allowed four telegrams to be sent over the same wires at the same time. He formulated new device by which the Roman alphabet could be transmitted by telegraph instead of Morse and dots and dashes. With the help of his son, Edison set up his new laboratory at Menlo Park. He made some improvements in bells, telephones and invented the instrument called microphone. Then he directed his attention towards talking machine. Edison's invention of phonograph was hailed as a scientific sensation of the century. He observed carefully William Wallace's dynamo. The idea of electric lamp excited his imagination. He did not lot of research work in this field, and his research produced research. Glass bulbs were emptied at air with vacuum pumps, so that the stuff which was to be put inside would glow but could not burn up when the electric current began to flow through it. The great problem was what stuff to use. He used the tiny length of cotton thread. The bulb burned for over 40 hours. He invited everyone to wanted to see his electric lamps at Menlo Park. It was Edison who inaugurated the electric age. He was proclaimed the greatest American of his day, among the innumerable inventions. The followed electric lamp, the kinetoscope, stands out Edison's most popular achievement. His next attempt to was tackle the problems of the motion picture, but he did not invent cinematography. He did some research work in this field. Edison was a legend of his own time. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe.